Hello, my name is Paul Brolin, and I'm a GaN design engineer in Texas Instruments. Today I will be discussing the advantages of building a 1.4 kV multi-kilowatt grid converter with TI GaN. In this presentation, I will discuss application and market trend for grid converters, traditional design approach and its pros and cons, comparison of multi-level topologies, advantages of TI GaN and multi-level converters, overview of TI's multi-level solution and performance results, followed up with a conclusion. The grid tie converter is a bidirectional three-phase power factor corrected AC to DC converter. This allows the converter to take power from the grid or supply power back to the grid. Power factor correction is required to minimize the AC RMS current and limit the current harmonic distortion. The grid tie converter is a very flexible building block for many grid tie power supply applications. In solar applications, it can convert DC power from solar panels to provide green power to the AC grid. It can charge an EV battery from the AC grid. In storage applications, the grid tie converter can level power usage on the grid by charging a storage battery when there is excess power available on the grid, or supplying power to the grid during peak loads. It is also a PFC front-end converter for high power supply applications that require three-phase AC input. In traditional grid tie converters, the power supply is comprised of three IGBT half bridges in a three-phase configuration, as can be seen in the figure on the right. The IGBTs are typical in a module package and switch at frequencies up to 20 kHz, with efficiencies in the 96 to 98% range. This topology is simple to design and has served the industry for many years. As the requirement for higher efficiency and higher density is becoming the norm, grid-tie power supplies are migrating to multi-level topologies. Multi-level topologies reduce the voltage switch to enable higher switching frequencies and smaller magnetics. For example, the typical topology seen in the solar string inverter industry today is the T-type NPC converter for buses up to 1000 volts and three-level NPC converters for buses up to 1500 volts. Multi-level topologies provide many advantages by reducing the voltage that is switched. Lower voltage power devices have a better switching figure of merit, or FOM, than higher voltage devices. Therefore, a 600 volt GaN device will have a lower switching loss than a 1200 volt silicon carbide MOSFET when switching at the same voltage. The reduced switching losses allow the switching frequency to be increased while maintaining high efficiency. The higher switching frequency and lower switching voltage reduces the volt seconds seen by the magnetics to allow for significant reduction in size and cost of the power inductor and EMI filter to improve power density. In some multi-level topologies, the power component losses are better distributed. This can enable smaller surface mount devices to be used and operated at higher ambient temperatures. When choosing the best power device for a multi-level converter, a power supply design engineer can use a spider graph like the one shown on the right. This spider graph compares the relative merits of silicon, silicon carbide, and GaN devices. The five attributes compared are VDS voltage rating, reliability, cost, switching losses, and QRR. Silicon devices, typically superjunction MOSFETs, are the incumbent solution for many switching power supplies. They have been around for many years and have been cost optimized. Multi-level converters typically are designed with a half bridge and a hard switch configuration. In half bridge configurations, MOSFETs have high switching losses due to their high reverse recovery charge and low switching figure of merit. Silicon carbide MOSFETs have significantly reduced switching losses over silicon MOSFETs, but have higher cost. Silicon carbide MOSFETs have a good performance in high voltage applications when 1200 volts or higher is required. GaN devices have the lowest switching losses because they have the lowest output capacitance and zero reverse recovery. Today, GaN devices typically have a voltage rating of 600 volts. Multi-level topologies enable the power supply designer to take advantage of GaN's switching performance and higher power applications that use higher AC voltages. To determine the best topology for a 5 kilowatt grid tie converter, several topologies were analyzed. For 1200 volt devices like silicon carbide MOSFETs, the two-level and T-type topologies were investigated. When designing with the 600 volt GaN devices, the three-level ANPC and four-level flying capacitor topologies were investigated. The two-level topology has the advantages of simple control and the minimum number of devices. The half-bridge design and control is well understood. By looking at the circuit schematic, it would seem to be the best topology. But if this is the case, why are many PV inverters adopting the T-type topology? The two-level converter switches the full DC bus voltage every cycle. It has the largest voltage seen by both the inductor and the power devices. This increases the inductor size and increases the switching losses. The T-type converter splits the bus voltage in half and adds two 600-volt silicon carbide MOSFETs that switch to the middle of the bus voltage. The voltage applied to the inductor and the 1200-volt silicon carbide MOSFETs is half the DC bus voltage. This reduces the size of the inductor and reduces switching losses to improve power density and efficiency. In applications such as the PV inverter, the power flow is unidirectional. The switching of the 600-volt devices are 0-volt switched. Therefore, those devices can be low-cost silicon MOSFETs. If the converter is bi-directional, the 600-volt devices will be hard-switched. Therefore, silicon carbide MOSFETs are the best choice. The ANPC and flying capacitor 4-level are multi-level topologies that have switching devices with a lower voltage rating than the bus voltage. These topologies enable the use of lower voltage devices and lower switching losses, such as 600 volt GaN devices. In the ANPC topology, the voltage seen by the inductor and the GaN FET is half the DC bus voltage. The low switching losses of the GaN FETs enable high switching frequency. Additionally, PWM3 modulation is used to effectively double the switching frequency seen by the inductor. These three items combined allow for a significantly smaller inductor than the T-type topology. However, the ANPC topology suffers from uneven loss distribution in the GaN devices and has a complex PWM control to balance the neutral point voltage. The flying capacitor 4-level topology, or FC4L, is a 4-level converter using the same number of power devices as the ANPC topology. The flying capacitors reduce the voltage seen by the GaN FETs in the inductor to 1/3 of the DC bus voltage. Additionally, the switching frequency seen by the inductor is tripled. This allows the inductor to be even smaller than the ANPC topology. Also, the power losses in the GaN FETs are evenly distributed between the devices, making thermal design much easier. When designing an inverter, power supply designers always trade off power density, cost, and efficiency. The top graph shows the relative system volume of the different topologies when designed for 99% efficiency. The gray area is the filter inductor size, and the top light blue is the heatsink volume. The two-level silicon carbide half-bridge topology suffers low power density. The large inductor size is the result of switching the full DC bus voltage at low switching frequency. The silicon carbide T-type and GaN ANPC topologies reduce the switching voltage in half and have much smaller magnetics. Overall, 4-level flying capacitor has the smallest inductor and provides the highest power density solution. The bottom graph shows the relative system cost breakdown. The yellow area is the cost of the inductor and green area is the cost of the power devices. An interesting finding is, in comparison, by adding more power devices in a multi-level topology, the cost of the passives go down. Even with the increased cost of the power devices, the overall system cost goes down. Greater than 4-level topologies were also investigated, but the cost of the additional power devices and associated circuitry is higher than the savings on the filter passives. Therefore, the 4-level flying capacitor provides the best optimization for this application. Shown here is a simulation of the 4-level flying capacitor inverter. The top plot shows the grid side current of phase A, B, and C. The bottom plot shows the voltage of the 800 volt DC bus in pink, 533 volt flying capacitor C2 in blue, and the 300 volt flying capacitor C1 in green. In this inverter, the voltage on the flying capacitors are self-balanced without active control. The table on the right shows the different switching states of the inverter. When looking at the S1X column, a 1 means S11A is on and S12A is off. A 0 means S11A is off and S12A is on. For each state, the SWA column defines the voltage seen at the SWA node. In columns C1 and C2, a plus sign denotes the capacitor is charging. A minus sign denotes the capacitor is discharging. A 0 denotes the capacitor is staying constant. The rate of charge and discharge is determined by the load current. By rotating through states 2A, 2B, 2C, or 3A, 3B, 3C, the capacitor voltages will remain balanced. Let's take a detailed look at the modulation scheme of the 4-level flying capacitor inverter. The graph on the right is a zoom in at the arrow point in the AC output current plot. The top row is 320-degree phase-shifted carriers for the switching pairs S1, S2, S3. The red horizontal line is the modulation. In the highlighted interval, the inverter generates a voltage of VDC at node SWA. In this state, the devices S11A, S21A, and S31A are on, connecting VDC to SWA. The current flow is indicated by the red arrow on the schematic. In this state, the load current does not flow through the flying capacitors. In the next interval, S31A turns off and S32A turns on to generate 2/3 of VDC at node SWA. Following the red arrow on the schematic, the voltage on node SWA is VDC minus the voltage of C1. During this state, C1 is charged with the load current. In the next interval, the switches return to the previous configuration and applies VDC to node SWA. In this state, S11A turns off and S12A turns on. The voltage on SWA is equal to the voltage on C2, which is equal to 2/3 of VDC. The load current is discharging C2. The next state returns to all the top devices on again, and SWA is equal to VDC. In the last state, device S21A is turned off, and S22A is turned on. The voltage at SWA is 2/3 VDC. It is defined by VDC minus the voltage of C2, plus the voltage of C1. The load current charges C2 and discharges C1, which balances the flying capacitor voltages. As previously discussed, the 4-level flying capacitor topology reduces the voltage applied to the power devices, enabling the use of more efficient switching devices such as GaN. The low output capacitance and zero reverse recovery of GaN FETs significantly reduce switching losses in a half-bridge configuration. TI GaN FETs with integrated driver further reduce switching losses by enabling high slew rate switching without Miller shoot-through and gate ringing. TI GaN devices incorporate lossless overcurrent and thermal protection to enable a robust power supply design. A fault logic output informs the power supply controller that a fault has occurred. TI GaN devices have a surge rating of 720 volts to enable the power supply to provide power during balancing and line transients. TI GaN devices utilize a low inductance package with an optimized driver. This enables near ideal switching CCM waveforms with very low ringing to reduce GaN FET stress and EMI. TI GaN devices are reliable in half-bridge applications switching continuous inductor current and have less than a 1-fit voltage failure rate for a 10-year lifetime. TI GaN devices are reliable when operated under extreme conditions. TI 600-volt GaN device is surge rated to 720 volts for a limited amount of cycles. The surge rating enables the power supply designer to develop a power supply that is reliable and continues to deliver power to the load during a surge event. As can be seen in the plot on the left, TI's GaN device reliably delivers 1 kilowatt to the load when a bus voltage surges to 720 volts. TI's integrated current limit is lossless and high speed to protect the GaN FET in a short circuit or overload. As can be seen on the plot on the right, the current limit is cycle by cycle to enable the power supply to operate through system transients without shutting down the power supply. On the right is a photo of a bidirectional three-phase AC to DC GaN converter utilizing the four-level flying capacitor topology. This converter was optimized to deliver 5 kilowatts from 400 volt three-phase AC to 800 volt DC with only natural convection for cooling. With 600 volt GaN FETs, the DC voltage can go as high as 1400 volts. This converter uses 18 LMG3410R050 GaN devices rated at 50 milliohms and 600 volts. The converter switches at 140 kHz and uses a TI C2000 DSP for power supply control. Here are the performance results of this converter. On the left is a scope plot of the flying capacitor voltages on channel 1 and channel 2. The voltages are flat and stable, demonstrating the topology self-balances the capacitors without active control. Channel 3 and 4 are the AC voltage and current of one phase of the converter. The voltage and current are smooth and in phase, demonstrating good PFC performance with low THD. The plot on the top right shows the switching waveforms of the three half bridges in the converter. The GaN devices are switching with a high slew rate of 100 volts per nanosecond and have a maximum overshoot of 80 volts with little ringing. The plot in the lower left is the measured system efficiency in both PFC and inverter mode. The system efficiency is independent of power flow direction. The converter efficiency is 99% from 3 kilowatts to 5 kilowatts, dropping to 97.5% at 1 kilowatt while using only natural convection cooling. The four-level flying capacitor topology utilizing TI's LMG3410R050 GaN device is an optimized solution for next-generation grid-tied converters. This topology provides a low cost with high efficiency and high power density while eliminating cooling fans. The four-level topology reduces the voltage across the power devices and filters to 1/3 of the DC bus voltage. The reduced voltage enables high-efficiency 600-volt GaN devices to be used and reduces the size of both the power and EMI inductor and capacitors. The four-level flying capacitor converter also evenly distributes the heat in the power devices to simplify cooling. Utilizing GaN as the power switch allows the power supply designer to increase the switching frequency to further reduce the filter components to improve power density while maintaining high efficiency. Utilizing TI GaN FET with integrated driver and protection enables the power supply designer to develop efficient, robust, and cost-effective power solutions. To learn more about TI GaN and GaN solutions, please visit www.ti.com/GaN. Thank you.